This video tutorial is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will review the requirements for chapter numbering and demonstrate how to apply chapter numbering to your document. Chapter-based numbering requires extensive modification of existing word styles and should only be applied last after all other formatting has been applied. Essentially, this system applies automated numbering of all chapters, subheadings, and captions according to their location in the document. Thus, it is easy for Word to make errors if all other styles have not been applied, as it may not know how to read the already formatted text in the document. This tutorial will proceed with the understanding that all chapter headings, subheadings, and captions have been formatted, as shown in the previous tutorials. To implement chapter numbering, you will need to add multi-level listing to the Heading 1 style. Because we will be making extensive changes throughout the document, I'm going to use the View tab to open the navigation pane. You may also use the Draft mode within the View tab, if you prefer. The navigation pane pulls from the heading styles to create a bookmark bar similar to that of the PDF document. I'll use this to navigate rather than scroll through the entire document. Now that I can see the entire document, I'm going to start with chapter numbering at the start of my first chapter. Place your cursor next to the chapter heading with the Heading 1 style applied. Go to the Home tab in the ribbon, and from the Paragraph section, select the Multi-Level List button. Within the List library, select the far right option in the middle row. Now go back and open the same menu, and choose Define New Multi-Level List so that we can modify our option. Within the dialog box, go to the Enter formatting for number and type chapter in all caps before the number. Click OK. This will insert the text chapter before every chapter heading. The default word settings also insert a small tab between the automatic heading and the heading title. As I originally typed chapter 1 manually, I'm going to go back through my chapter and delete this text since it is now unnecessary. Because the chapter numbering applies to Heading 1, any styles based off of Heading 1, such as pre-content, will receive a chapter number. To remove this, go to the pre-content style in the Styles window and right-click to open the editing menu. Choose Modify. From the Modify menu, open the Format menu in the bottom left corner and choose Numbering. From the Numbering library, click None. This removes numbering from the pre-content style. Click OK until you return to the document. The pre-content sections should no longer be numbered. In order to remove numbering from the references and appendices, you will need to create a new style to remove the numbering, as we have just done for the pre-content sections. Within the Style section of the Home tab, click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner. From the Styles window, choose Create New Style from the bottom left corner. For the title of the style, I'm going to type No Numbers. Make sure that the style is based on Heading 1, then go to the Format menu and select Numbering from the drop-down list. In the Numbering library, select None. Click OK until you return to the document. Now go to the References and Appendices and apply the No Numbering style to all section headings that require the Heading 1 style but should not be numbered as a chapter. The list of tables and list of figures should also have the No Numbering style applied. Once you're done, go back up to the Table of Contents. Highlight the Table of Contents and go to the References tab in the ribbon to select Update Table. Check the Table of Contents to ensure that it contains all appropriate chapter headings. If you don't like how the chapter numbering looks, you can always modify it later. I prefer to have a colon between my chapter and chapter title, so I can go back to the Define New Multi-Level List menu to make some modifications. Because I prefer the text to be closer together, I can go back to the menu, place the colon in the text box, open the More menu, and change the Follow Number With box to Space. You can format your chapter headings in a number of ways, just be sure you do it consistently throughout the document. This concludes the video tutorial for chapter numbering. If you have any further questions, please use the ETD help request form available through the Thesis and Dissertation Services website. In the next video, I will review the use of caption numbering.